I was looking for proof that what I was trying to achieve was impossible. I needed some piece of evidence to say, you know what, this is not going to work, and here's the evidence as to why. And I just decided I would keep going until I got that evidence.
Stick-to-itness and thinking outside the box are characteristics heaped in great abundance on Chris Griffiths. After apprenticing in guitar repair and opening his own shop at the age of 19, Chris formulated a thought that would revolutionize acoustic guitar building. Chris Griffiths, recipient of the 2003 Award of Distinction.
I think the first time I really started thinking a little bit more outside of the box and really questioning how things are done and why and if there's a better way would probably be back when I was about 12 years old and I got an electric guitar for Christmas. I've been playing acoustic for a little while and got my first electric, and by Boxing Day I had it completely disassembled, and I was so convinced that I would find a better way to put it back together and I could set it up better and really add a lot of value to it.
Chris Griffiths loves guitars. He loves playing them. He loves building them and improving the process. But finding a better way to do something is one thing. Messing with 170 years of tradition is something again.
I actually didn't come about my innovation by looking at traditional guitar building and saying, there's something wrong with 170 years with a tradition. The way I actually came about the innovation was quite backwards. I actually wasn't building a guitar at the time. I was taking one apart. And it was when I took a guitar apart and I saw the interrelation of all the internal reinforcements in the body of an acoustic guitar and how they related to each other. And I realized at that time that they had so much more in common that, you know, traditional guitar making was just not taking advantage of. And, literally it took me 6 minutes to come up with this concept and 6 years to make it work. When you tune the strings of an acoustic guitar to pitch, it puts about 150 pounds of tension on the top of the acoustic guitar, which needs to be counteracted because our top is less than an eighth of an inch thick, and it's typically a softwood. So unless we reinforce this top, it's literally going to explode as soon as we tune the guitar. But that's pretty straightforward. From an engineering point of view, we can counteract 150 pounds of string tension without much problem. But the interesting challenge is that the top of an acoustic guitar works like the speaker in your stereo. The more it vibrates, the better it's going to sound. So that really means that the more we reinforce it, the more we're restricting its ability to vibrate. So as we counteract string tension, we start taking away very positive tonal qualities. This is what the inside of most acoustic guitars look like. However, these are typically individual pieces of wood that are machined one at a time and installed one at a time. And this perimeter right here is called a kerfing and binding combination. Those are also manufactured separately and installed separately. So you've got about 2.5 hours worth of labor that goes into just manufacturing these components. We make this part in 45 seconds. Instead of making all these braces out of wood one at a time and then gluing them all to the underside of the top to reinforce from string tension, we make this all as one piece. So no matter where you create a vibration along the top of the guitar, that vibration has an uninterrupted path to transmit itself through the entire instrument. And that's how you get an acoustic benefit, whereas at the same time, we're adding structural integrity to the instrument because a glass fiber composite is doing a great job counteracting that string tension.
To improve the technology and tone of a musical instrument without altering its appearance is quite a challenge, elegantly achieved by the Griffiths Active Bracing System for acoustic guitars.
From 3 or 4 feet away, it looks very traditional, and until you walk up closely and maybe look inside the sound hole, you would never tell that there's really anything innovative about this instrument. But part of the discipline was, you know, what components in this instrument do we want to apply this theory and this technology to, and what do we want to leave more traditional? And basically, for your $800, Garrison is offering you a new technology, a great sounding guitar that looks very traditional, sounds beautiful, and is easy to play. I guess we're going to build about 12,000 guitars this year. We're exporting to 23 different countries. It's a very exciting time, but the company's also still quite new. And it's fascinating to me, once you really open your eyes to what's possible and gain a little bit of confidence from surviving some failures and achieving some successes, that there's so much opportunity out there. It really is not about finding an opportunity, but having the discipline and the smarts as to knowing which opportunity to choose to explore. I think good ideas are a dime a dozen. I think good innovation is the execution of really great ideas. Innovation's about making mistakes, and lots of them, but fewer mistakes than wins. Canada as a country really stands out as a group of innovators who aren't just there producing, but who are thinking up new ideas, trying new products, accepting the failures and really celebrating the successes at the same time. I think that's really what makes Canada stand apart.